up. So the neck is a quadrilateral structure which is divided into two triangles, the anterior triangle and the posterior triangle, by this key muscle. This muscle is the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Now let's see the boundaries of the posterior triangle. So the posterior triangle is bounded anteriorly by the posterior border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. So this is the sternocleidomastoid muscle, and this is the posterior border of the sternocleidomastoid. And posteriorly by the anterior boundary of the trapezius muscle. So this is trapezius, and it is also forming the posterior boundary of the posterior triangle. The base is formed by the medial 1/3 of the clavicle, and the apex is formed by joining the joining point of the trapezius and the sternocleidomastoid muscle. So somewhere here. Now let's see what are the structures which will be forming the roof of the posterior triangle. So the roof of the posterior triangle will be formed by the skin, the superficial cutaneous nerves, and also the deep layer of the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia. So the roof will be formed by all these structures, and the floor will be formed by the prevertebral fascia, so which will be extending from the trapezius to the sternocleidomastoid muscle. So the floor, if we see the muscles which are present in the floor of the posterior triangle from the top to the bottom, so first muscle is the splenius capitis. Sometimes we can also see one small muscle here, that is the semispinalis capitis, and the fibers of the semispinalis capitis are vertically oriented, whereas all the muscles of the floor of the posterior triangles are running obliquely like this, in this direction. So after this muscle is the levator scapulae muscle. So this is the levator scapulae muscle, and this is the scalenius posterior muscle, and just beneath the scalenius posterior we also have this muscle, that is the scalenius anterior muscle. Sometimes we can also see one more muscle here, that is the scalenius medius muscle, and sometimes we also have one more muscle here, that is the scalenius anterior muscle. The triangle is divided into two parts by this muscle, the small belly of muscle, that is the inferior belly of the omohyoid. So one large upper triangle, and below this you have one smaller triangle. So above this muscle, this triangle is the occipital triangle, and below this inferior belly of omohyoid we have one small triangle, that is the supraclavicular triangle. Now let's see the contents of this triangle. So first content is this nerve. This nerve is the spinal accessory nerve. This nerve pierces the posterior border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle and runs over this muscle, that is the levator scapulae muscle. It runs parallelly along this muscle, and then it disappears in the trapezius. It is when it goes into the trapezius, it is around 5 centimeters above the clavicle. Now if we see the cutaneous nerves which are present in the posterior triangle, first cutaneous nerve which we can see here is this great auricular nerve, which is supplying the auricle and also the angle of the mandible. Then we also have one more nerve which is not present here, that is the lesser occipital that is also supplying the cranial part of the pinna. And this nerve is the transverse cervical nerve. So this nerve just runs across the sternocleidomastoid muscle and supplies the neck, front of the neck. And we can see these muscles which are these nerves. So these nerves are the supraclavicular nerve. They are actually three nerves which are coming from this single point, and these nerves are the medial, intermediate and lateral supraclavicular nerves. After this we can see one more content here. This is the dorsal scapular nerve. So it takes origin from the C5 root and it runs deep to the levator scapulae muscle. We can also see some branches, C2 and C3 and C4 branches of the cervical nerves. If we talk about the arteries, the blood vessels which we can see in the posterior triangle, so we can see this artery, this is actually transverse cervical vein and the transverse cervical artery, which is coming from the first, from the thyrocervical trunk, which is actually coming from the first part of the subclavian artery, and this is the transverse cervical vein. Then we can also see the trunk of the brachial plexus. So this is the trunk of the brachial plexus, this one. So this is also a specimen which is taken from a book, and in which we can see the posterior triangle, and here we can see this muscle which is dividing the posterior triangle into a bigger occipital triangle above and a smaller subclavian or a supraclavicular triangle below. So this is the inferior belly of omohyoid. And what else we can see here? We can see the great auricular nerve, the transverse cervical nerve, and the supraclavicular nerves here. And one more thing which we can see here is this, the external jugular vein, which is piercing the roof of the posterior triangle and is entering into the which is piercing and draining into the subclavian vein. And this we have already seen, this was the transverse cervical vein, and beneath this we have the subclavian artery also, the third part of the subclavian artery also, which is a content of the supraclavicular triangle. That is why the supraclavicular triangle is also known as the subclavian triangle, because the subclavian artery and the vein is present in this triangle. Now this is a more deeper dissection in which we can see the so this is the third part of the subclavian artery. So this is the subclavian artery, the first part, and below this muscle, this is carinus anterior muscle, this is the second part, and this is the third part. So we can see the third part of subclavian artery in the supraclavicular triangle, and from the first part we can see that few branches are coming, that is the thyrocervical trunk, and from that thyrocervical trunk we can see the transverse cervical artery, which is a content of the occipital triangle. So this is the transverse cervical artery, and we can also see the suprascapular artery, which is also coming from the thyrocervical trunk.